We have a demo alum, Helen Greiner, who's going to talk to us about the future of industrial drones. And this is what her next company is about. She launched iRobot at demo. She's not launching this company here, but she's been thinking a lot about drones. Helen, welcome.
Well, thanks. I want to give my pre-congratulations and the congratulations to everyone who participated, but the folks who become demo gods today, because I've done hundreds of talks since, and every time someone introduces me, they always highlight, they look at my resume and they say, oh, demo god. So of course that makes the real gods of demos want to smite all my demos with a jealous rage, but you know, that's okay because it's a really cool title to have. So I launched iRobot on the demo stage, I think 14 years ago, and it's been successful, well, beyond our expectations, not beyond our wildest dreams. It's now a publicly traded company. It's got a market cap of $1 billion. We have 10 million Roomba vacuuming robots in people's homes, and thousands of military robots out that have been credited with saving the lives of hundreds of soldiers and thousands of civilians. So, you know, we couldn't be more proud of that. But today I'm here to talk about drones. And why? Well, it's easy. If you look around this room, think of you're a small ground robot. What do you see? You see all these chairs and tables and people, all these obstacles are in your way. But you go up 10 feet and it's incredibly open space. So with drones, we get to cheat, which I like doing. And then you go outside and you know, there's roads and there's traffic, there's cars, there's trees, there's plants, there's mud, there's puddles. There's all these things that are basically just obstacles. But you go up like 200 feet, it's clear space. It's like we've left a route for the drones to use. So the kind of drones we're concentrating on at Sci-Fi Works are industrial drones. And these robots will be operating around expensive equipment. They'll be operating near employees, near customers, and the people that are operating them will be taking responsibility for their safety and reliability, and they'll also take a responsibility, they'll have liability for them. So the premium is different from a drone you might buy as a toy or as a hobbyist. The premium is really on safety and reliability and a lot of these other characteristics. So the way we're going to accomplish this is we've brought together UAV experts with roboticists who have taken part in the development and production of many of the successful robots that are out there doing real work for real people today. So this is what I see as the market today, where most of the drones are doing entertaining, recording, getting great aerial imagery. I'm going to come back to this slide, so just take you through the green one first. What do you do when you start a company that's going to build drones? Well, you go out and buy the coolest drone toys, hobby equipment that you can. So I went and bought the coolest toy at the time, the Blade system. And then, just a little while later, another company, Parrot, came out with the AR drone, and it was cool on a different axis. You could bring it indoors. It got into distribution channels like Brookstones and SkyMall. And then 3D robotics came along, and they opened it up to hobbyists by making them more programmable, more easy to add other stuff to it. And then DJI came out, they've been doing hobby stuff for many, many years. They came out with a more consumer-oriented drone. It carries a GoPro, and it's really, really cool, highly recommended. It's a ton of fun. And then that company, and then 3D Robotics came out with one that also is a more turnkey, more for the people that just want to fly a camera system. And then that company that I started with, the Blade, saw that these were selling well, so they came out with one like it. So that's kind of the last, 7 years of hobby drones. And there's lots of others on the market. I just highlighted the really popular ones. So people will ask me sometimes, why isn't Sci-Fi Works doing this? And the answer is, well, unlike when we put the Roomba on the market, at that time there was nothing that cost effective to do the vacuuming. There was nothing already in Far East manufacture, and there was things that you could build an IP moat around your product with. So I love hobby drones. I buy them all. And I believe they will sell, you know, consumer products are measured in the millions of, you know, success in the millions of units per year. And I believe they'll get there, but I think it's going to be split between the people in the market and the new players that come along, and they're going to be able to do dogfights, they're going to be able to follow you around, they're going to be able to swarm, they're going to be able to do all these really, really fun, cool things. But now back to what we're actually doing at Sci-Fi Works. We believe the market in the next few years is going to be protecting and inspecting. So one of our robots is shown here. It's an indoor flying robot. So you come up to a situation. You either want to clear a building as a military, as a soldier, or you're a police officer and you want to go into a hostage situation without putting your teammates at risk. What you can do is send one of these systems in first. So we're pushing this forward. We're making a smaller version that's with the police officer, with the soldier, wherever they go. There's another robot that we're building. Notice I do think of them as robots. This is called the Park. And you send the Park up, and it stays there 24/7. And from that vantage point, it sees an entire facility. So it's got a bird's eye view. And so the way we're doing that, the 24/7 operation, it's not solar powered, it's not laser systems. We believe as engineers that the simplest solution is usually the best one. So we're actually tethering it to the ground with a very, very long tether that we call a microfilament. And that supplies power and communications. So this robot's sitting there, and it's got cameras on it and sensors on it. And it's kind of like having a near-Earth satellite system. A lot of people are using imagery from satellite systems. And you have to do that if you're looking at an entire continent. But a lot of people are just using it for their particular facility. And when you're using it for just one facility, with our system, you get very high-resolution data. You get real-time operation, and it's up there 24/7. And it can see if somebody's sneaking in. It can see things, where all your assets are. It can do security. It can do safety. It can do oversight. There's many, many applications once you have this platform in the air. So this is the Park system. And it's just showing a test flight. And I got to say, we do the most boring demos. I wouldn't get demo god for this. Because you set an altitude with a slider, you push a button, and it flies. And then it just stays there. So it doesn't do dances, it doesn't do flips, it doesn't jump through hoops, and it doesn't juggle. But most of our customers aren't asking for those things. What they really want is a platform that they can use to get the kind of sensor readings that they want. So the microfilament technology, it does high-definition video. It does secure communications. And a lot of people, just for fun, hacking into the wireless links of drones today, we avoid all that problem by having it connected to the ground. And interference is a huge issue if you go to a crowded location with lots of links. So there'll be a combat outpost protecting our soldiers. So you can see that area around the outpost. At larger bases, they have these big aerostats, but you can't get those out to places where there's just a few dozen guys because they're too expensive and they weigh tons. So we're getting these out there with the same kind of programs that I used to get the iRobot PackBot into service. They're called rapid equipping programs. They'll also be inspecting. Anytime you want to see how your equipment is faring, whether it's an oil rig or a bridge or a cell tower or a, or a wind farm, anytime it's really tough to get eyeballs to the right places, that should be a drone doing the job. So that's protecting and inspecting. Next out is in orange is evaluating and managing. so you can basically think of these as data platforms. And you know, the software to fly and to get video coming back is you know, comes with the system, of course. But there's such a great opportunity to do analytics and to write expert systems around that data, which is why one of the reasons I'm here. I know a lot of people in this room are working on analytical solutions. I want you to think of robots as a potential capture platform. So the easiest example is video analytics. You can see what's going on at your entire facility automatically, and then start to say if there's anomalies going on. And then you start to think of it as managing your facility, and that's where the artificial intelligence comes in. And we believe it, you know, we're opening it up to third-party developers because the people in the world that are experts at how plants grow, how ports operate, where the mining equipment should be, how a construction project should be run, and getting the expert systems as a service for our customers. So the exciting thing about it is there's lots of industries that these types of drones are applicable for, because it solves one of the big problems that these things have. You send another drone up, by the time you get to the place it's supposed to be looking at, it's already out of batteries and you have to bring it down again. So just one example in mining, this robot could be doing intrusion detection, it could be doing asset management, and it can be making sure people are following safety protocols. All are very huge to our customers. And then, of course, no talk about drones would be complete today without talking about delivery. And I got to say, I am a believer. Many of you know Jeff Bezos from Amazon came on 60 Minutes late last year and said, you know, they're going to provide a service maybe 5 years out to deliver from packages via via drones. And this is from a talk I gave last summer at a TED conference saying, well, you know, what we're going to do with the drones, you know, one of the big, I don't like to say killer apps, but one of the big first applications for these types of systems is as the fulfillment centers get closer to cities, it really does that last mile of getting the goods to people in, you know, it's about instant gratification these days, right? Instant gratification takes too long, I think Carrie Fisher said, and, you know, people are used to getting their packages, you know, not just a week from now, not just overnight, but not just the same day, but in 30 minutes or so, and I think that is possible with this technology. So this is the kind of list that you need to work with, the requirements for a delivery drone. And it's remarkably similar, in fact, exactly the list that I put up first for the industrial drone. So, you know, when you think of custom requirements, you know, putting the packages in an aerodynamic body, you know, our system carries 5 pounds of payload because that's what we need to carry the high fidelity cameras. And airworthiness, if anyone tells you that they're going to fly a drone over a city without FAA approval and an airworthiness certificate for that drone and any changes made to that drone, well, they're probably flying a little too high themselves because it really is about safety. So we consider this our sweet spot. So the future of drones is really, really bright. I think we've come up with a plan that meets the current regulatory restrictions, the commercial restrictions on flying drones, because with the tethered systems, you are allowed to fly to, they're not characterized by the FAA as unmanned systems or drones. And we're looking to for the future applications using this same technology. And I'm doing this because I do believe the next wave of robots will be flying robots, and I want to do everything I can to push that forward. So thank you for your time, and if you have any questions about robots, drones in general, I hope you'll come up and talk to me. Thank you.